We are today learning more about the victims killed in this tragedy, a refugee who tried to fight Joel Cauchi, a young bride-to-be and a Sydney architect. They're among those being remembered today for who they were, not for how they died.
A sea of flowers growing as waves of insurmountable grief hit the community for the loss of six people robbed of their futures. A besotted new mother, a 25-year-old bride-to-be, counting down the months to her big day. A mum of two raising her family in Bellevue Hill. A security guard who lost his own life protecting others. And two women from overseas, thousands of kilometres away from their families.
She just was a beautiful soul. She never said anything bad about anyone, and she just wanted to be a mum, and she'd been given that opportunity, and then 9 months later, it's gone, and it's, yeah, I can't, yeah.
Andrew Reid tried desperately to save some of the victims, not realising his friend of 10 years, Ash Good, was among those fatally wounded. This is the woman he remembers. Bright, always smiling, and a beautiful person.
Beautiful baby was 9 months old, and yeah, it was all, you know, it was all ahead of her, and that was just taken away in the blink of an eye, and it's horrible.
From Ash's family today, she was a beautiful mother, daughter, sister, partner, friend, all-round, outstanding human, and so much more. While her daughter, also injured by the same attacker, after hours of surgery is doing well, we are so grateful for the expert care and attention of the medical team. Ash's family asking that this photo be how she is remembered and not for the crime that killed her.
Remember the woman. Remember who she was, which was that kind, loving, peaceful, present, athletic, brilliant woman.
The 38-year-old and her partner, who was also injured, are known and loved across Australia. The South Australian Premier, a family friend.
I've been speaking on the phone this morning to a family member. It's pretty bad. It is incomprehensible that such a beautiful family has been so aggressively affected.
Unimaginable pain felt also by the family of Dawn Singleton, the 25-year-old daughter of media magnate John Singleton, murdered in the shopping centre attack. She was the apple of her father's eye, her nickname Dawny Perfect, given to one of his racehorses. Police today speaking with the family in their Vaucluse home.
Now, whether you know the individuals who've been killed or not, you're grieving today, and the entire state will have to get behind those families in the days ahead.
Dawn was months away from getting married, her partner, a serving police officer, from her former school. It is devastating to learn of the death of Kambala old girl Dawn, Dawny Singleton. Each victim of this horrible crime is being remembered today. Architect and mother of two, Jade Young, as a lovely, kind-hearted woman, a devoted member of the Bronte Surf Lifesaving Club. 30-year-old security guard and former refugee Faraz Tahir also killed. Those who loved him today honoured his unwavering dedication and kindness. A man who fled persecution in Pakistan and tried to protect innocent people under attack in his new home. Six people, loved, loving, and lost to us all. Samara Gardner for 10 News First.
10 people remain in hospital following the attack, including the 9-month-old baby daughter of victim Ash Good. Keziah Dawn is outside the Sydney Children's Hospital. Keziah, what's the latest on the baby's condition?
Chris, that 9-month-old baby girl is critical and in ICU as we go to air this evening, but she is stable. Friends of family have visited the hospital here today, but as you can imagine, it is an incredibly distressing time. Now, I can also confirm there are 9 other patients in hospitals around Sydney. That brings the total to 10. Now, I'll run you through where some of those are. We have 2 in St. Vincent's, 1 24-year-old male and 1 22-year-old female are both in ICU. They came in last night with stab wounds. Another elderly woman presented herself this morning. She was running from the ordeal. and she remains in the hospital as well. Two are at Royal Prince Alfred. One male is in a stable condition on a ward. One female is in ICU. Two females are at Prince of Wales. They are both stable, as well as another at St George. And a woman is in ICU at Royal North Shore. She is still in a serious condition. However, she is stable. Now, St Vincent's released a statement today sending well wishes to all of those who still have a long road to recovery. They also confirmed that the Premier, Chris Minns, and the Health Minister, Ryan Park, visited the hospital today to say thank you to emergency and ICU staff. They did that without media, but Chris, staff at hospitals right across Sydney have worked tirelessly, but there is still a long way to go.
Thanks, Keziah. Keziah Dawn joining us live from the Sydney Children's Hospital.